Good Tuesday evening and welcome to the NCW Life Evening News. I'm Grant Olson. Before we get to what's making news, let's take a look outside our weather window from this afternoon. And boy, not a bad day out there today. We did see a mix of clouds and sun and even a band of low-hanging clouds. Possibly, as Malcolm and I were talking, it could be smoke from area fireplaces, wood stoves, etc. Very, very calm wind out there. Here's another shot looking down from Omi Gardens at the Wenatchee Valley. And wasn't a bad day today, although our temperatures were still a little bit below normal, and that means it's still cold enough that we could still see some of that freezing rain that greeted us this morning. We're talking about a tenth to maybe 2/10 of an inch of ice accumulation overnight tonight. So what we dealt with this morning could be a lot what we're dealing with tomorrow morning as well. And we'll talk much more weather. It's going to warm up coming up a little bit later on. And now a few of the stories we're following for you tonight. It was a hazard of a different sort that forced the closure of eastbound I-90 for more than 2 hours near Snoqualmie Pass Monday night. The Washington National Guard arrived in Leavenworth on Monday afternoon to help residents still recovering from last week's winter storm. And a new drive-thru COVID-19 testing site has been set up at the Town Toyota Center right here in Wenatchee. But first, our top story tonight. A 39-year-old Mattawa man has died from injuries he sustained in a two-vehicle wreck on New Year's Day. The Washington State Patrol said Diego Soto Diaz died at Cadillac Medical Center in Richland, where he was taken after the 5 p.m. accident. The State Patrol said Diaz was driving south on Highway 243 outside Mattawa when his 2002 Dodge Neon crossed the center line into the path of a 2015 Nissan Altima, which was driven by 53-year-old Antonio Magdaleno of Desert Air. Magdaleno attempted to swerve, but his vehicle was struck by the Neon before leaving the roadway and striking an electrical box. Both men were transported to Cadillac. The extent of Magdaleno's injuries has not been released. Well, it was a hazard of a different sort that forced the closure of eastbound I-90 for more than 2 hours near Snoqualmie Pass last night. The Washington State Patrol said just after 5 p.m., a pickup rolled about 9 miles west of Clee Ellum and spilled a load of roofing screws into the roadway. Between the vehicle and the screws, both lanes of the interstate needed to be blocked for that cleanup. The State Patrol said the unidentified driver of the pickup suffered minor injuries. The Washington National Guard arrived in Leavenworth on Monday afternoon to help residents still recovering from last week's winter storm. The 23 Guard members first got a briefing from Mayor Carl Floria and then went house to house checking to make sure occupants were safe and able to leave their homes and that they had enough food and supplies. They also helped clear snow for citizens who weren't able to do so on their own. Leavenworth received 36 inches of snow in Thursday's blizzard and up to a foot more in some places. Hazards left behind include heavy snow load on roofs and garages and a pair of water leaks that have flooded residential streets. Today was the first day back in class for students in Leavenworth schools since the storm struck. A new drive-thru COVID-19 testing site has been set up at the Town Toyota Center in Wenatchee. The Chelan Douglas Health District opened the site Monday morning, and the free testing will be offered Monday through Saturday from 10:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. The health district says there is no appointment necessary for the tests. Kent Sisson of the health district said they're using rapid antigen tests with the results in approximately 15 to 20 minutes sent via text message. Well, coming up next, the price for a new home last month was up compared to last year, and active listings were way up. That's the latest real estate snapshot from Pacific Appraisal Associates. The pedestrian-friendly plan for Leavenworth's main shopping avenue will remain in place at least until spring. The Leavenworth National Fish Hatchery has been under 50 inches of snow since Thursday, but that hasn't stopped its efforts to improve in the way it preserves salmon populations. And deep snow in the mountains and foothills of north central Washington is pushing wildlife, especially deer, into communities throughout the region. I'm Grant Olson, and you're watching the NCW Life Evening News.
At Wenatchee Power Sports, we proudly offer the Polaris product line. Polaris builds the highest quality side-by-side in the industry, with off-road capability that's second to none. The Polaris pre-order program allows customers to purchase the vehicle they want without having to select from limited dealer inventory. The Wenatchee Valley has year-round access to some of the best ORV trails in the Northwest. Start your adventure here at Wenatchee Power Sports.
At D.A. Davidson in Wenatchee, they believe your investment success begins with a personalized plan. A plan that is the roadmap you need to navigate your way to living your best years in retirement. D.A. Davidson can help you create a plan so you can take the time to enjoy the finer things in life. Let the financial advisors at D.A. Davidson help chart your retirement future today.
Let Mary Maid's custom cleaning experts help you clean up your to-do list. Between work, kids, and pets, it's hard to find time to keep up. Let Mary Maid's of Wenatchee help. Mary Maid's cleaning experts can help keep your home or business fresh, neat, and exactly how you'd clean it if you only had the time. Call now for a free estimate, 509-663-1710. Serving Chelan and Douglas counties. Mary Maid's, let us help.
Welcome back. In another news, the price for a new home last month was up compared to last year, and active listings were way up. That's the latest real estate snapshot from a Pacific Appraisal Associates. The median sales price of a home in Wenatchee in December was $440,000. That's up 18% compared to last December, when the price for a home was $372,250. Active home listings were up at 56, we're at 56 rather. That's up 81% compared to last year when there were 31 listings. Total home sales in December of 2021 were also up 10% at 99 compared to 90 sold homes in 2020. The Wenatchee residential market consists of Wenatchee, East Wenatchee, Malaga, Arondo, and Rock Island. The pedestrian-friendly plan for Leavenworth's main shopping avenue will remain in place at least until spring. City officials in the Bavarian-themed town closed Front Street to vehicle traffic in 2020 as the COVID-19 crisis took hold. The idea was to keep people from crowding too near each other on the sidewalks, but the solution has proved popular as well as profitable for downtown merchants. Leavenworth's mayor on December 30th extended the emergency order that keeps cars off Front Street through April 15th. Mayor Carl Floria says the rise of the highly transmissible Omicron variant made the extension necessary. The city is debating whether to permanently exclude vehicle traffic and parking in that area. Speaking of Leavenworth, the Leavenworth National Fish Hatchery has been under 50 inches of snow since Thursday, but that hasn't stopped its effort to improve in the way it preserves salmon populations. Four new fish-rearing circular tanks are ready to raise spring Chinook salmon smolts once the weather warms up. The vats were installed this month as a part of a new five-year pilot project. Fish managers say raising smolts in circular tanks rather than along raceway may increase fish health, decrease the hatchery's water usage, and improve the quality of the water it discharges back into Icicle Creek. Biologists will monitor and evaluate all fish raised in the new tanks, hoping to raise stronger salmon for their journey to the Pacific Ocean and back. Deep snow in the mountains and foothills of north central Washington is pushing wildlife, especially deer, into communities throughout the region. The state says residents should not feed the deer that wander into their yards and warned that doing so could actually cause more harm than good. The State Department of Fish and Wildlife says deer have remarkable abilities to survive winter conditions without human help. Samantha Montgomery of the Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife said, despite images of deer neck deep in snow that have circulated on social media, the animals are generally able to adapt to the conditions despite occasional disruptions to their mobility. You're watching the NCWLIFE Evening News. Coming up next, tonight's feature story and your complete local weather forecast. That and much more still to come on the NCWLIFE Evening News. Please stay with us.
Since 1932, Camp Zuniga, nestled on the beautiful shores of Lake Wenatchee, has provided children grades 1 through 12 with the ideal location for kids to learn new skills, have fun, and make friends while creating memories that will last a lifetime. Camp Zuniga's rustic log cabins and their staff serve to provide each group a unique summer camp experience. Register for Camp Zuniga today, www.campfirencw.org.
What is home? A place to gather, a place to grow, provide shelter for the ones we love, eat, drink, restore, build trust. It's a place to rest when the work day is done, a place to find quiet after a night of good fun. What an honor we have at Guild to help own, finance, create, pave the way to live in home.
Are you a take charge kind of person? Consider a career as a health unit coordinator. You'll work to keep health facilities running efficiently by coordinating medical providers, patients, and departments. The Charter College Certificate in Health Unit Coordinator program can get you up to speed on basic patient care, health records management, health and safety procedures, and medical billing. And the 10-month online program includes a computer you keep. Get started at chartercollege.edu, where we work to get you to work.
Welcome back to the NCWLIFE Evening News. In tonight's feature story, Washington's Secretary of Transportation said yesterday that mandates for COVID-19 vaccination had no impact on his agency's handling of the January 6th snowstorm. About 140 WashDOT employees refused to be vaccinated and left the agency after shots were required last year. In a House Transportation Committee hearing, State Representative Tom Dent of the 13th District asked Secretary Roger Miller about the staffing issue.
We've let, I think you said around 140 people as of October 18th were let go. We've hired quite a few more, but we still have some of those people out there that possibly could be hired back. And my question or my concern is, I don't know why we couldn't hire some of these folks back, vaccinated or not, to put them in a truck by themselves, working by themselves, to keep our major east-west thoroughfare commerce highway open.
Yeah, we have rehired some of those people. They've gone and gotten vaccinated and they've come back work for us. But you know, the last time people ask, when was the last time this happened? The last time this happened was back in 2009. Very different staffing situation from today. But as I said earlier, Mother Nature calls the shots at the end of the day. We don't go up there and battle Mother Nature. She does her thing. And when it's not safe to be there, it doesn't matter how many people you have on the team. But we have gotten the highway open and operational, and we continue to do good work. We are down some staff. We were down staff before the pandemic. We were down staff because of the pandemic. Again, a solution to our staffing problems, one of the solutions is vaccinations, because we don't have to quarantine people for as long. They're able to come back to work earlier. The sickness they get, if they are exposed to it and get sick, is less serious than it was before. The vaccinations, to me, are not a problem. They're part of the solution to the problem. The problem is the pandemic and the economic consequences of the pandemic and the economic consequences of decisions we've made in the past in terms of the staffing and equipment levels at the Washington State DOT.
Time to take a check now of your North Central Washington weather forecast. Hope your Tuesday was a good one. Kind of a blah kind of winter day out there today. We did see a little bit of sunshine at times. Boy, but it made for just a beautiful, dramatic shot looking down from our Omi Garden Sky-Fi Tower camera.
and of course the Columbia River. And we did see a little bit of cloud cover, low-hanging clouds, and some mid-level clouds out there. We're not quite done with this possible freezing rain yet, but then things are going to get nice and warm as we get into the end of the week. Today, we reached an unofficial high temperature of 30 degrees. 33 is where we should be for this time of year. 53, our record high temperature. That was set back in 2014. 18 is where we started our day this morning, so a nice warm-up throughout the day today. 24 is our normal low temperature. Record cold on this date was in 1974, 1 degree below zero. We're still at 1.18 inches of precipitation since January 1st. That's a pretty good start, and our snowfall, of course, way up there, 42.8 inches. Sunrise, 7:46, and the sun set this afternoon at 4:32. Dick, going ahead now and taking a look at our temperatures for your hump day Wednesday, and we are in for a nice warm up beginning tomorrow and going right through the end of the week. 36 in Moses Lake and Ephrata, 37 for you folks in Quincy, 38 degrees. We're hoping for it here in Wenatchee tomorrow, and it looks like 38s all the way up the Highway 97 corridor, Chelan, and also you folks up in the Omak Okanagan area. You'll see a high tomorrow of 38 degrees. Taking a look now, tonight we will see cloudy skies, still about a 50% chance for that freezing rain as this area of low pressure taps into this river, atmospheric river, and that's bringing lots of rain, especially into western Washington. We might catch just the edge of that overnight tonight, so don't be surprised if you see a sheen of ice on those windshields tomorrow. 30% chance of rain tomorrow. Not very positive or very sure that we're going to see anything tomorrow. It's going to be warmer too. Look at this. High temperatures, we talked about it, in the upper 30s. And then as we get you into Thursday, big old ridge of high pressure once again up and over the Pacific Northwest. That means warmer temperatures for Thursday, where we could see high temperatures near 40 degrees. Won't that feel nice? For Friday, partly cloudy, still mild out there with high temperatures in the upper 30s. So get ready for lots of slush and standing water all around the Wenatchee Valley from all that snow with these warmer temperatures. As we get you into the weekend, Saturday looks nice, mostly cloudy skies, passing clouds. We could see a good shot of sun in the afternoon Saturday with high temperatures in the mid to upper 30s. Getting you into Sunday, mostly cloudy. We'll call it fair with high temperatures once again in the mid 30s. That's still just slightly above where we should be. And then Monday, still under the influence of high pressure. That means warmer temperatures again, partly cloudy on Monday with high temperatures at the end of our forecast. Very nice into the upper 30s. Let's take a look now at your 7-day forecast. Tonight we will drop down. Look at that, 30 the high. We're only going to go down about 2 degrees tonight to 28 degrees and then go up. I think this should be about 38 for our Wednesday, cloudy and warmer. 40 degrees on Thursday, 29 our low, and we're going to stay dry and fairly mild right through our Friday into the weekend with highs in the mid 30s, and then a short warm up once again on Monday, partly cloudy skies Monday with a high temperature of 38. And that's a look at your local weather forecast. Coming up next, tonight's sports report with Dan Kuntz, rather, and more as the NCW Life Evening News continues right after this.
Bring the whole family up to Stormy Mountain Brewing and Local Public House in historic downtown Chelan. Applewood smoked brisket, street-style tacos, and our award-winning barbecue rubs and sauces. Our meals pair perfectly with our exciting lineup of craft ales, made right here in Chelan. We've got room for big groups, or give us a call for catering. So grab the kids and check out the fun at Stormy Mountain Brewing and Local Public House, located in the heart of Chelan.
News, weather, and sports. It's all here weekdays at 5, 6, and 10 on your local news source, the NCW Life Channel.
Connect with us on Networked as we introduce you to the people and organizations who are leading innovation in the region. Get inspired, engaged, and networked right here on the NCW Life Channel.
And now it's a sports update on the NCW Life Channel.
Hello, sports fans. Dan Kuntz filling in for Eric Granstrom. The Georgia Bulldogs are the champions of college football. They knocked off number one Alabama for the national championship last night in Indianapolis. The final 33-18 for Georgia, their first national championship since 1980. Walk-on senior quarterback Stenson Bennett was the hero for the Bulldogs. 224 yards, a couple of touchdowns with a victory. The big blow towards the end of the game when Tacoma native Keely Ringo intercepted the Heisman-winning trophy quarterback Bryce Young, returned it 79 yards for a touchdown. After the game, Georgia head coach Kirby Smart said he didn't want him to go all the way into the end zone.
A sad thing is I was screaming to get down, and that was the wrong play there. You know, I saw the receiver coming behind him, and pessimistic thought or whatever, I was worried about the guy stripping the ball from behind. And then I realized 11 wasn't going to catch Keely. And once I realized 11 wasn't going to catch Keely, I didn't want to get a holding call on Channing. And all I could think about was get down, we can win this game, run the clock out. You know, if they don't have timeouts there, the play is to get down. But they did have three timeouts, so they probably could have got the ball back. So going up two scores was the right move. And probably a little prematurely, I felt like we had won the national championship. But, you know, we still had to get a stop because they could score two-point and get it onside. And I was a little concerned with that. But it was ironic because the ball was in the air. You know, all we've done this year is throw balls to our DBs. You can ask Lewis. We've thrown millions of balls because of playing the ball in the air. And when that ball was in the air, I said, he's going to catch this thing. We're going to win this game. And he did.
Alabama coach Nick Saban said he's very proud of his team, but they just didn't win the fourth quarter.
And I just feel really poorly that we didn't finish the game better than we did in the fourth quarter, because we played a heck of a game against a heck of a team. You know, for the first three quarters of the game, you know, congratulate Georgia for the job that they did. But nobody can take the SEC championship away from this team, the Cotton Bowl championship. And I'm extremely proud of everything that this team had to overcome to get to this position, to have an opportunity to win the national championship. We just didn't finish the way we needed to finish.
Yeah, Alabama wins the Cotton Bowl. Alabama wins the SEC championship. But Georgia, the national champions. The Seahawks continue to pack up their gear at the VMAC in Renton, making their tee times and heading into the offseason. Coach Pete Carroll says they have already begun evaluating this year's team with film study and statistics.
When we get back going again, is to take all the information that we've accumulated, all of the numbers and the stats and all of the printouts that we have, to tell us all of the background, and we'll go through everything, to how much they were able to practice and time missed and all of that, reps, who they matched up against, and all of that stuff, to just make individual evaluations on each guy. We really go, both sides of the ball, we'll go watch individual cut-ups of each guy as an entire staff, so that we can kind of make a collective, you know, evaluation, and we have the presentation of their statistics that support all of that, and we'll try to make a real clear evaluation of where the guy sits, you know, at that point. And then, of course, we compare the other guys that are there, and start to put together a whole, you know, a whole program of understanding our guys better than we've ever have. And so, it's an exhaustive process for us, and we go through it with the intent of figuring out what we can do to help that guy be better.
Of course, it was a disappointing season for the Seahawks, 7-10. They didn't make the playoffs. One of the biggest reasons it was a disappointing season, third down conversions. The offense couldn't get too many. The defense couldn't stop them.
You know, I'm not trying to cover up anything. I want to know the truth of what's going on. That's the whole point, is to get to the truth of it and figure it out and analyze it, and then you know, track our way back through the process and see where could we have done better. You know, where could we have been farther ahead on third downs, you know, for us through the process. How much did we work on it? Did we get enough? Were we missing the point? Did we not stress third and three through six enough, you know, and versus 7-10s and all of that stuff, you know, anyway, there's a ton of stuff here to deal with.
As you probably heard by now, backup quarterback Geno Smith arrested for suspicion of driving under the influence. This happened early Monday morning. Coach Pete Carroll had nothing to say about the situation other than that Smith was at the team meeting in Renton later on Monday morning. We'll have a lot more from Coach Carroll and the players now that the Seahawks season has come to an end. The Kraken can't seem to win a game. A valiant effort against Colorado last night down in Denver. They had a two-goal lead at one point, couldn't hold on. The Avalanche got the victory. Here are your highlights.
To the near side, McKay. A tries to give it back up top to his captain. That's the return pass. Cross ice to the circle with a shot. Score! Deflected in front by Johansson. Up over the pad of Brandt Sows for his third of the season. And the Seattle Kraken with a power play goal have tied the game at one. And again, the Avalanche PK continues to be a work in progress. Carr saw Eberle coming. Score! A shot from McCann at the hashes. He just fired it to the front of the net, and it somehow eluded Pavel Francouz to give the Kraken a 2-1 lead.
I'll tell you
what's interesting. There's a sin up top. Alexia, yeah, pieces. Score! It was deflected by Colin Blackwell, who pops it past the glove hand of Francouz. And all of a sudden, the Kraken have a 3-1 lead. Burakovsky sweeping in, shoots, what a kick save. Rebound, score! Grubauer made the first save, but he could not make the second save. Nicholas Alvey-Kubel with his second goal of the night. Lines Taves, back to Kale. A shimmy move and his shot, off the post, score! Devon Taves cleans up on the near side. McCarr got it through, it rang off the iron, and Taves able to put it home for his seventh goal of the season. Lazon left the handle on the near side. It's knocked ahead for Jost, he'll give it up for Kadri. Abs trying to get numbers, Kadri is in with the shot, he scores! Nazem Kadri, top shelf! One all the way down, and that will do it. The Avalanche come back from a two-goal deficit and beat the Seattle Kraken by a final score of 4-3.
Kraken now have a six-game losing streak. They'll try and snap that tomorrow. They'll be in Dallas to take on the Stars. They'll drop the puck at 5:30 on Root Sports Northwest. All right, your prep schedule today. As far as we know, all of these are on. In girls basketball, Quincy will host OMAC at 5:45. Later on at 6, we got Brewster Lake Roosevelt. Madison hosting Okanagan, and Soap Lake visits Antioch. On the boys' schedule, same as the girls, just a little bit later. OMAC and Quincy will tip off in Quincy at 7:15. Brewster is at Lake Roosevelt at 7:30. That's also the same start time for Okanagan and Manson and Soap Lake at Antioch. And it's wrestling time. Eastmont and Wenatchee back on the mats tonight. The Wildcats will host the Cadets. The Panthers will visit the Rams. Both of those get underway at 7 o'clock tonight. And those are just some of the games that people are playing on this Tuesday. Grant, back to you.
Thank you very much, Dan. And now let's go right back to Dan Koontz for a look at what's coming up on his regular gig tomorrow morning on Wake Up Wenatchee Valley. Dan?
Thank you very much, Grant. Tomorrow, my guests will be Michael Kinter and Mariah Thornock. They are both members of Wenatchee Rotary. Their biannual auction is coming up. They do it every other year. It's coming up at the end of this month. We'll talk about all the great items up for bid and all the good works that Wenatchee Rotary does with Mariah and Michael. They'll be my guests tomorrow. Plus, we'll have that wintry forecast. We'll get you caught up with the ever-widening world of sports and everything you need to start your Wednesday. And I believe it's Winning Wednesday, too, tomorrow. That's an even bigger excuse to watch this program. Winning Wednesday tomorrow morning begins at 7 a.m. on Wake Up Wenatchee Valley. Grant, back to you.
Thank you very much, Dan. And that's going to do it for our newscast tonight. For more on these stories and other news from around North Central Washington, you can find us on Facebook or our website at ncwlife.com. And remember, if you see news happening, we'd like to hear from you. You can send us an email at news@ncwlife.com or give us a call at 888-NCWL. That's 888-6295. I'm Grant Olson. Thanks for joining us and have a great night. News, weather, and sports. It's all here weekdays at 5, 6, and 10 on your local news source, the NCW Life Channel.
Counterplay inside, picking his way back to the 10, to the 5.
High school sports is back, and NCW Life Channel's got you covered. Tune in for football, girls soccer, and volleyball right here. Thanks to our sponsors, Harvest Valley Pest Control, Rivercom 911, and Sangster Motors. Follow all the action of high school sports on your local TV station, the NCW Life Channel.